Give me your love, just give me your love, just give me your yeah, just give me your love. What the hell, yeah, yeah. Just give me your love.
Got your back.
Lift you up when you fall.
Like dominoes.
Watch them fall, baby.
Girl, you fine when you break it down. Got them other shorties mad when you come around.
Yeah, so tell a girl, say you're sitting down. Some vibe to live
up. Watch how I turn up on you, yeah, yeah. Love the way how you move, yeah, yeah. And I love what you do, yeah, yeah. Can't take my mind off of you, baby. Shake you down, baby, it's a robbery. Can't miss a chance, this ain't no monopoly. Used to be wild, now this a monogamy. Can't lose even mama proud of me.
Me used to have enough gal on my team. Gal from Brooklyn, gal from Queens. Used to do anything, just forget in between. Now me move like a king, I'ma find me a queen, baby. Royalty, that's how you think about. Are you Taurus, did I sing about?
I'm shaking down, serious. Hey, Hubies, what's happening? All right, we live on the podcast, baby. It's been a while, and I know that much. It's been a while. You know, but we had to get our shit together, because that's where you want all of your shit. If you're talking about this life, and you're talking about life going well, you want your shit all in one neat fucking pile. You want your shit together. Now, why do we say that? Because this is a thing we heard somebody else say. Does it make any sense? No, it does not. But I guess you don't want shit all over the place. You know what I mean? But if anybody who's experienced in dealing with shit, you know, whether it's all together or it's all over the place, you don't want the shit anyway. So why do we even say that? None of that matters. You know what I mean? But we back, baby. We back, baby. If you don't know, this is the ReHubie podcast. You know what I'm saying? This is ridiculous human beings, because that's what we are. We're ridiculous. You understand what I'm saying? And a lot of ridiculous things happen between now and my last podcast. And maybe we'll get into it. Maybe we won't. You know why? Because we're just freestyling this. Because I just sit in this seat and I just fucking wing it. And sometimes when you wing it, you fucking forget shit. Okay, but you don't. You know what we're not going to forget? We're not going to forget how we like to start this fucking podcast off. You understand what I'm saying? And we like to start it off with our main man, our fucking guy. Fucking Anthony Hyland, man. Now, I don't know what this is. Now, I see something that he did, all right? And he's doing things on TikTok. Shout out to him on TikTok. His TikTok is, it's now iScorpion 1906, I think. I don't know, all right? But it's him with a big-ass fucking head. He's got a big old head. He's got an army uniform on. I think in a preview that I saw another time, he was maybe telling some jokes about the military. Who the fuck knows? We're going to find out right now. But you know that if this guy's telling fucking jokes, I'm in, all right? Because that's what we do here. We tell jokes. Now, if he's going to do the thing that I do, which is tell jokes, I'm fucking in. So I'm going to show you guys on a live, and I'm basically going to be watching it with you as well. Now, this thing has 105,000 views. That means 105,000 people maybe found this entertaining, all right? And we're going to see what the fuck he's talking about, what the fuck he's even doing. It's just him with a giant head, all right? This is his TikTok there. You can see him in the middle there doing a fucked up Harlem shake with a big-ass fucking head, all right? So it's Hyland High time, and thankfully he's got TikTok, because this is the funniest shit ever is him on TikTok. All right, so let's hit the button and let's see what the fuck he's talking about.
Hey Dad, I'm gonna work at Old Navy.
Oh yeah?
Yep, I signed up at school.
You did?
Yeah, some guys came in and talked to us and tried to get us all to work there.
Oh. What?
He said if we signed up, we got free education and training, cost-effective healthcare, and get this. Military discounts.
I get the joke already.
I think you signed up for the Navy.
That's
the
not Navy.
No, that's the actual Navy.
Okay, I was wondering why they never brought up their springtime collection or their 40% off sale. I'm like, that's an attention grabber right there. That's something you bring up.
I see what this is.
I can't believe I'm in the Navy.
Well, you're.
Hey, Dad, I'm going to work at Old Navy.
Oh, yeah?
Okay.
Yeah,
okay. So true to who and what he is and what he's got going on, that was much less creative and much less fucking entertaining than I even thought it was going to be. I'll tell you what that was. There's a dude who's on social media. He's a comedian. He's a gay dude. And he does shit like that right there. He does those monologues there with himself and people always voicing the shits over. Okay? And that's what the fuck he just did. Okay? It was an old Navy military joke. He thought he was going to signing up to be in old Navy, but he signed up to be in the Navy. All right. Doo-doo. Okay? Fucking funny, I guess. All right? Because that's what's hilarious now. Now when the dude does it, it's funny. You know what I mean? Because he does a little role play thing. But Hyland just did it. And I am supremely underwhelmed. Okay? Because let me tell you some shit about people in the military. All right? Let me tell you some shit about the military in general. Military, law enforcement, all of that shit. All of that shit. Okay? Let me tell you some shit about that shit. Now, those are jobs, all right, where you can die. All right? The military and stuff, the military, first responders, law enforcement, those are jobs where you can die. Okay? The one thing that always fucks me up about people who have those jobs is the complaining. All right? What is it that you're complaining about? When you signed up for that job, the possibility that you might die was already with you before you signed up for the fucking job. Now, don't get on the job and say, this job is dangerous. Motherfucker, this doesn't get more dangerous than you could die. And you knew that before you got the fucking job. Okay? One thing I do agree with, pay them motherfuckers. Pay them, all right? Because they could die. First day out could be the last day out. They could fucking die. But what you don't get to do if you're military, law enforcement, first responder, is fucking complain, all right? If you're scared to die, get a different job, okay? Because let me tell you something, and we're talking about the U.S. here, you know what I mean? I don't know how it works everywhere else, but in the U.S., you can choose to enlist. You choose, okay? So when you choose a job where you can die, you don't get to complain about the fact that you can die. Okay, that should be a general rule of thumb. Okay, because fuck that shit. If you feel like you had a better skill set or a better value on this planet, you wouldn't go join the fucking suicide squad. All right, you would go do that thing and you go fucking live. All right, because that's what we want to do. We want to go to work, not really, but we want to make money, sure, but we want to live through it. Okay. So if you go to military, you go to law enforcement, you go to first responder, and you're complaining about the fact that you can die, you're a fucking idiot. You're a fucking idiot. That's the first and foremost concern in that shit. You know what I'm saying? And as a matter of fact, I think that's how they fire motherfuckers in those jobs. You feel me? They just keep giving you jobs where you can die until you die. You know what I'm saying? Imagine that. That's how that's got to work in the fucking army. All right, if you're the dumbest guys, because they take like everybody, you know what I'm saying? If you don't get taken by a you can die job, God damn me, you're pretty low on the pole. You know what I'm saying? Because if just the mere fact of being alive and being physically able is, you know, is your qualification, if you're not even those two, at the very least, guy, fuck your life. That's one. Two, that's how they got to be firing motherfuckers. You know what I'm saying? Like, why would I put up, if I was a smart man, you know, and I'm in these military first responder, whatever have you, why would I argue with a stupid motherfucker? Why would I do that? I would just send you on all the death stuff. You know, I can get rid of you that way, you know, because if you don't think that stuff there's a sacrificial element to that stuff, you're out of your goddamn mind. You haven't been paying attention in history. There's always a group that goes out there just to die, that they sent out there just to fucking die. You know what I'm saying? So they could kill off a bunch of y'all while some other guys kill the guys that are killing you. That's what war is. I don't know if you fucking know, but that's how wars are fought. Okay, people die. You know what I mean? And if a part of your job is the possibility of war, I mean, come the fuck on. You know, the last thing we got for you is real sympathy. You know what I'm saying? Fuck that shit. You chose it. You chose a death job. Now, I don't have a death job. I don't have a death job. Which means, I mean, I'm not talking shit. You know what I'm saying? But I fully know my place. in how this shit works. I figured out early on in life that I don't want a job where I could probably die. You know, the likelihood was high that I'm just going to be dying. So I just didn't go get one of those fucking jobs, you know, which I don't think that's rocket science. You know, but apparently to some people it fucking is. And thank you very much. That's our installment of Highland High. Shout out to him and everything that he keeps doing, you know, because it just keeps us fucking laughing. So I'll tell you what else we got going on. We got our second segment that we like so much. We got Ben Backwards. All right. Ben Backwards. Now, shout out to Ben. Okay. Now, Ben, the last time we saw him, he was giving us the tips on how he increased his salary and all of that fly shit. You know what I mean? Shout out to DJ Cav, man. And now he's doing all kind of motivational speaker fly shit. You know what I'm saying? And I like when I see shit like that, because you get to just look at the person. Okay. Like, why are you qualified to tell me what to do with my life? What did you do with yours? You know what I'm saying? If you're out here fucking up like I'm fucking up, I don't want to take advice from you. Or so we would think. You know what I'm saying? Because it's a double-edged sword. If you're fucking up like I'm fucking up, if you did it before me, then maybe, you know, Hov did that. So hopefully you don't have to go through that. That's the general rule of things, and I get that. But you can't be out here fucking up alongside me, you know, and then being my goddamn life coach. You know what I mean? People think that going through shit qualifies them to tell other people what to do with their lives, you know? And of course, there's some merit to that, but mostly it's just you, I guess, making it public that you have poor decision-making skills. You know what I'm saying? And whether or not you learn from those remains to be seen, but you just kind of tell us about it and tell us don't do it, and then we just feed into the shit. But you're just publicizing that you are, were, or have been, or maybe will be a piece of shit, you know, and that's you being a motivational speaker, you know. The whole thing is like, don't be like me, you know, okay, but what did you do? Who are you? What are you good at? You know, you're good at telling us that you fucked up. Okay, you know, so we're gonna get into Ben back, and he's doing some stuff. He's got some graphics on here, some generic graphics and shit on here, and it says three qualities of successful people, because this motherfucker knows you only got to be three goddamn things to be successful. Ask me if he's successful, don't know. Ask him if he's successful. Don't know the answer to that. I don't know the answer to that. Ask him. I would like to know the answer to that. You know, maybe if I see him again, I'll ask him. I want to fucking interview him. How about that? And we'll ask the hard-hitting questions and find out what the fuck he got going on. So I'm going to show you the video, you know, and I'm going to be watching this video alongside you once again.
Most people that don't make decisions, they make choices based on their circumstances, their environment, and if it looks scary, they can't decide.
Okay.
Right? So the worst decision you can make is indecision, which means I'm not going to choose anything at all. I'm going to stay where I'm at, where it's safe and comfortable.
I'm calling bullshit already. Right? Calling bullshit. Like, yo,
you need to be able to make a yes or a no decision and accept the consequences of both.
Some truth to that. Some truth to that.
A decision.
Oh, he's talking to somebody. Like, yo,
you just told me you want 300K.
Oh.
You're not going to change that and say, okay, I'm comfortable with 60K. You're not going to say, maybe I'm comfortable with
400K. He might.
You said 300K. That's what we're sticking to. That doesn't change.
I don't know about all that now.
Committed. It's just like, yo, when you commit to something, this is where you burn your boats. There's no going back. That means when it get hard, difficult, easy, uncomfortable, whatever all right. It is, you find a way.
It was debatable before, but it's just morphing into bad advice.
What's it called? I forget his name right now, but he said there's a difference between being interested
because it's nobody and being committed. Because it's nobody, that's why.
Convenient. When you're committed, you do whatever it takes. You accept results. There are no excuses.
Who's motivated by this?
And most people are like, yeah, I'm committed, but no, you're not. And you prove that by your actions and your choices. And I'm just like, yo, you got to be coachable.
This man's choice of hairstyle is...
This is what my coach tells me, and I tell every client that I'm...
Interesting, to say the least.
Do what I ask you to do.
Ask.
Until you find out I don't know what I'm talking about or I'm lying to you.
Right. Which is right now. I found out already.
Do it.
Fucking found out already.
Until you find out I'm lying and I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm not gonna lie to you, know exactly what I'm talking about. So don't bring your square into this circle. It don't work that way.
Don't bring your square into like, this circle. You gotta be resourceful. What does that even mean?
Most times when people fail, they're just like, oh, I don't have the time. I don't have the money.
Bullshit.
I don't have the resources. There's something always missing.
Bullshit. Right?
When we analyze why we didn't get where we wanted to get.
Bullshit.
And resourceful means it's just like, yo, when it seems like there's no way, you find a way.
I don't know.
You knock on the front door, it's closed, you go to the back door. That's closed, you look for a window.
What is he talking about?
You blow the house down to get inside.
Don't do that.
You find a way.
Oh, I said some words there. What the fuck does it say? Oh, my God.
Most people.
All right. Now, that, I would say that was 98% bad advice. 98% bad advice. I'm trying to figure out what it says there. Learn how to go from coaching your friends and family for free to charging premium prices for your coaching program. That's what it says. That's what he wants us to do. Now, we just got world-class fucking advice from Ben Bakayoko. Shout out to him. Okay? And he said, blow the house down in order to get into the door. Now, that's exactly what we don't want to do. You know, he was going somewhere when he said the door ain't open, find a window or find the back door, whatever have you. Okay, we get that, you know, but when we get into the house, we want the house intact. Okay, this blow the house down is an understanding of how they say cutting the nose despite the face. Okay, we wanted the face with the nose on there. We wanted the house with the rest of the house in there. Don C say, blow the house down, pause. That's a hard pause. Hard pause. But if, I mean, goddamn me. If you know, if you see, you've seen the guy saying it. His marbles is all over the fucking place. I don't even think the pause matters. You know what I'm saying? Shout to Ra. Yeah, I mean, he in the live too. Shout to Ra. So I don't even think that shit matters. Now, don't blow the house down in any fucking sense, right? Of that understanding. He just says the words. That's all it is. That's what that motivational speaker shit is. You just say the words. You say the words that get people excited. You know what I'm saying? The understanding of blowing up a house is exciting somebody. Some fucking body, you know. So they just saying all the things. Yes, Don C's three little fucking pigs. That's what he just now just hit us with. A fucking three little pigs motivational speech. You know what I'm saying? And this is what we're charging premium prices for, you know, according to him. Now, in that whole speech, I don't believe I heard anything useful, for one. For two, I don't think I've heard anything I've never heard before, you know. For three, I would like to know what the context was. Why the fuck was he telling somebody that? Because that's terrible, you know. That's like if somebody wants to rob a bank. Now, anybody could do that, you know. Anybody could just do that, could just go try to rob a bank. But the understanding is that when we rob the bank, we want to get away. You know, that's our understanding of success. We want the money and we want to come away from this unharmed. And that's the hindrance. That's why everybody's not robbing a bank. You know, the prospect of coming away from it unharmed is slim. You know, and that's why we don't do things by any means. You know, we do it by the most comfortable means, because we understand success as coming away from it, you know, intact, you know. And shout to Cav. He say, get the keys and make a copy. Now, hold on, okay? Because you could build a whole motivational speech out of that. That would probably be useful, understanding, you know, what the keys are. He did a whole door reference. He could have said what the keys are. And that has me thinking that the video said that is three qualities of a successful person. I don't even think he gave us three qualities of a successful person, but whatever. Yeah, you could say that a successful person creates the keys, you know, to said door and gets in, you know, that would work. He said some shit about resourcefulness and shit, but the shit was so scatterbrained and fucked up. Like, I couldn't tell you what the fuck he was even talking about. You know, and he gave some shit about some words, resourceful and shit like that. Like, it was just lies. The stuff that he said just wasn't true. Shout out to Cav. Yes, get the fucking keys. Okay, to the shit. And go that way. Oh my God. So yes, that's what we want to do. We want to get the keys. All right? And not the keys to giving flat out retarded advice the way he was doing right there. All right. Shout out to him. That's Ben Back with Ben Back Words. You guys just heard that. Hope you got motivated by it. Hope you fucking learned something. Ah. Now enough of that. All right, we might have to swing back to TikTok, and I'm gonna tell you why we're gonna swing back to TikTok. All right, now I have recently discovered something that we like to call dark talks. All right, dark talks. Okay, shout out to YMH, shout out to Christina P. Put me on game for dark talks. All right, every time I go on TikTok, man, they immediately show me a chick popping ass, you know, to some new song, you know, and sometimes it got the robot broad voice on the back of it. How you gonna have me popping ass? And then some chick is just popping some ass, and it's like, all right, I get it. You know what I'm saying? Like, I've seen this before. I don't need to go on TikTok to fucking see this. I mean, shout to Cowboy. He say he should have said rob the bank, then check your monthly statement. Oh boy, if you rob a bank and then you put the money in your bank account, guy. Guy, I'm not even gonna say too much about you and that. Matter of fact, you're gonna find out about yourself on these talks that I'm talking about right now. So there's dark talks out there, all right? The stuff on TikTok that TikTok doesn't want you to know exists. Okay, because real shit, damn near anybody could make a TikTok, all right, and they could start posting videos like immediately. You know what I'm saying? So what are all the people who are not doing squirrel dances on TikTok doing? Like, what are they doing? Well, I might be able to show you. You know what I'm saying? And maybe you'll become a fan of the dark talks too. So now when I open this fucking TikTok app, and this is what fucks me up. When I open this TikTok app, it's gonna be some stupid music shit on, usually. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's gonna be some young person doing something dumb to some new music. I get it, but it's not me. I don't fucking want it. But you gotta sit through a few seconds of it just because you opened the fucking app. It immediately shows you shit. And that's why people is brainwashed over this fucking TikTok, son. It doesn't stop. This immediately just fucks you up with the dumb shit as soon as you open it up. So what I'm saying is, I'm going to open up this app and the dumb shit is going to start immediately. Just pardon it. I'm going to try to make sure it doesn't happen. Or if I got the link to the fucking talk, which I do. I got some talks here. All right. Now, I don't know what these are. I got links to dark talks. All right. And I don't know what they are, but we're gonna find out. All right, I'm gonna show y'all the dark side of TikTok here. All right, shout out to it. See what we can do. See if we got it.
Oh. Okay, guys, let's do some dancing. Let's show me my moves. Sounds like cows are coming. Oh my God, the cows are chasing me. I better run. More cows are after me now. Even more cows are after me now. More cows are after me now. house, they won't stop chasing me. These cows can't stop chasing me at all. There's a whole lot of cows. Grab me now. I better run. This is a ton of cows right for me now.
All right. Enough of that. I'm hot now. Laughing so fucking hard. Oh my god. Oh fuck, dog. For everybody who's gonna just be listening to this. what that was a gentleman. Who we could surmise probably missing a few marbles. Okay. And he started off. Yes, Don C's, I am crying, boy. Shout to Cav. He must have had his metaverse lenses on. He must have. Yes, I am crying because that's funny to me. Okay, that shit is funny to me. That man, I know he ain't have all his marbles. All right, but who gave him a camera? All right, and who told him he could be in front of that shit doing shit? Now he started off with his best fucking dance moves. All right, his best fucking dance moves he started off with. You know, and that got me. But once he said the cows was chasing him, he said the cows was chasing him. There was no cows, man. There was no cows. He was doing donuts in an empty fucking field. It looked like he lived on a goddamn farm. What is he doing with a cell phone anyway? You know what I'm saying? I feel like he was by himself too. I feel like that's dangerous. It's dangerous for him to be by his fucking self doing that dance. For one, that dance was dangerous. Anybody get caught up in that, man? Goddamn me. You know what I'm saying? That was hardcore. Oh, man. Oh, God. You know what I'm saying? That's what's going on in the world. Now, when China made TikTok and they said they're going to steal America's data, that's the shit that they wanted. They want to know what's fuck's really going on. What's really going on out here in these streets and in these pastures and meadows, apparently. Okay? And that's what we got going on right there. Now, we got another one. I'm gonna see what this one is too. I don't even know. It might be the same one I'm hearing.
Finally got my way.
Oh nah. Now this one might be lit. This one might be lit. Oh no, that's the same dude.
Okay, huh. Guys.
All right, we're gonna do a different one. Let's get retarded in here. Now that was a little bit more commercial. That got the song in there. Well, for one, that song says "Let's get retarded." Now they changed it to "Let's get it started." That's like the version that goes, you know, that's everywhere, you know. And this dude, I dare say he was retarded. He said "Let's make that the retarded national anthem." All right, he said, "Let's get retarded." That's the song. You know what I'm saying? Let's make that the retarded national anthem. Now, I'm not opposed to that. I'm not opposed to that. You understand what I'm saying? You got to do what you got to do. Okay? And if Sun is God damn. See, that's the fucking app. That's what I'm talking about right there. That's what we hate about this shit. It's always trying to show you some fuck shit. Oh, man. Now, I want to show y'all another one. Now, this dude is Moonshine Legend, all right? And he be making whole fucking, and yes, Don C's, he was really real live retarded. But that's him, you know what I'm saying? I can't tell him, don't be, you know what I'm saying? Now, this is what happens again when you give motherfuckers internet, you know, and TikTok, okay? This motherfucker right here. This dude page is Moonshine Brian, all right? It says a Moonshine Legend. He be making little stories, okay, about him doing redneck shit, I think. You know what I'm saying? And then we're going to try to go to one of them and see the kind of shit that people are doing, you know, and see what's really going on in the world, all right?
See you later, alligator.
Oh, what?
See you later, alligator.
Oh, fuck that one. That was some bullshit. Let's see if we get another one going.
What's it noise? God damn it. It's always the goddamn police.
I'm going to prison. Woo!
I didn't do fucking nothing.
Got caught with that moonshine.
Guess I'll hit the yard.
Build the bird. Check out the gate.
I gotta get out here. Oh, shit, it's the police. God damn it. Why is there a big chicken in the road? Oh, no. I'm getting out of here.
This is a movie.
Holy shit, I'm in China. How in the hell am I gonna get home? Thanks, homie. You motherfucker, you are up here? I came all the way up here to get away from your fucking ass. Now I gotta leave. Whoa, nice kitty.
Well, I'm look, gonna lay
I, don't got, I don't even gotta show you too much of that. That's fucking Moonshine Legend. And for everybody who's listening, this motherfucker makes whole movies out of still backgrounds, green screening it, you know what I'm saying, and making simple fucking gestures. He make a whole redneck motherfucking movie, all right, doing that shit. And that's what happens when you're giving people internet who don't fucking deserve it, all right? Now, is it hours and hours of ridiculous entertainment? Sure. Should that motherfucker have been brushing his teeth instead? Absolutely. Okay, so you could check out Moonshine Legend on TikTok if you want to see some real dark talks, man. A whole dark talk movie. Okay, with that motherfucker. And you're never going to see him on a goddamn TikTok commercial. He's never going to pop up as soon as you open your app. Nothing like that. Okay, because that's the real shit right there. Okay, that nigga had to be on some motherfucking drugs. Had to be. Not some, all of the drugs. If you need the description of him, I think he's a pretty young guy. You know what I mean? I don't get old man vibes from him, but he looked like an old man. That boy got the bowl cut on top of his head, meaning the reverse bowl cut, the fucking George Jefferson. You know what I mean? He balding up there. And he ain't got no goddamn teeth. You heard him a little bit talking, you know what I'm saying? He only say a few sentences at a time because the motherfucker got no teeth. That's one thing I want out of my life. I'll take teeth over TikTok success. You understand what I'm saying? Like, that's how you know a lot of times too, who on some hardcore drugs, they don't got no teeth. And yeah, shout out to Don C's. That's exactly what I was thinking. Meth. It's meth. Yo, these redneck boys, man, when they ain't got no teeth, it be meth. And that's real shit. They be fuck you skinny a lot of times and they don't got no teeth and it be fucking meth, man. Tell you one time, I've been to the West Coast. I've been to fucking New Mexico, man. And I seen meth hitting switches. Now, and out here in New York, you don't see meth hitting like that because we had a crack epidemic. It was crack getting crazy. And it's close. You know what I'm saying? It's a close second to meth, I think. I think meth is the top slot. No, maybe PCP is the top slot. And then meth and then crack. You know what I'm saying? So I seen the meth boys out there getting swayzy like you never seen before. I seen people, they just got open wounds, like the meth stopped their body from functioning, from fucking doing the right thing. They wounds don't close. They just be having full open wounds on their body, man, and no goddamn teeth. And you like, damn, that's meth. You know what I'm saying? One thing I can say about PCP is I ain't never seen nobody on PCP just broken and fucked up and hurt. You know what I'm saying? Motherfuckers who smoke PCP get strong. They get strong, you know, and they start doing stuff. They become able. You know what I mean? You ever see in the West Coast, they be having them videos and shit of the cops trying to arrest people on PCP. Yo, that should be a ordeal, boy. That shit, maybe having a whole squad out for one dude. You know what I mean? He naked, walking around, strong, doing karate and shit. You feel me? That's PCP. That's the real Superman drug. I think that's probably what it was for. I think that is what it was for. You know what I'm saying? And when I'm saying that, that's not even a joke. You know what I mean? Real shit. A lot of people don't know the Nazis, man. Shout out to the Nazis. The Nazis was on cocaine a lot of the times. You know what I mean? When they was doing their thing, that's how you get ruthless. You not only do you get a fucking dictator up in the set. You know what I'm saying? Every time your boy's about to go on a mission, you hop them up on cocaine. Shit. They're gonna fight till they can't fight no more. You know what I'm saying? They be walking, running, shitting and pissing and still shooting. You feel me? Them boys be focused. That's how they was doing their thing. That's how you get one nation to conquer fucking half a fucking planet. Cocaine. Whole cocaine army. You know what I'm saying? So shout out to the Nazis and the cocaine. Coke addicts, man. That's who you get. That's how you get. That's why people started getting crack addicts. Now, crack will get you high. You know what I mean? But it won't do the consistent work of cocaine, because the cocaine high is so fleeting. You know what I mean? You got to keep sniffing. So you get these boys to keep sniffing. They keep get shit done. That's why we used to be in the hood. And every time you need something done, you call a crackhead. You know what I'm saying? The boys be focused. You feel me? And they want that rock. You feel me? More than anything else. That's what it is. You know what I'm saying? So Hitler wanted to conquer the world more than anything else. So what did he do? Hop them boys up on cocaine, baby. They get the job done. Feel me? So he's the original, you know, call a crackhead motherfucker. Feel me? He created that. You know what I'm saying? You want it done? Call a crackhead. You know, a cokehead in his case. You know what I'm saying? I guess the advanced version was the fucking crackhead. You know, they'll work for you for 2 days. Cokehead, they'll work for you one time. You can probably never see him again. You know, don't give them nothing. They won't be back. And that is how they say that. You know, so I'm going to try to bring out more of these dark talks in the future. You know what I mean? And we're going to see what's really going on in TikTok. I wish this was a better way I could show this to y'all on the lives and shit. You know what I'm saying? But I can't. but I fucking can't, you know. But shout out to the goddamn internet, shout out to social media. That's what we got going on nowadays. You know what I'm saying? Because again, every time I open TikTok, it's a chick popping ass, because that's what we want. That's what we want to see with our lives. You know what I'm saying? Everybody, even the chicks, is watching that shit, because that's just what the fuck it is, you know. And that's what it's gonna be. You know what I'm saying? And it's wild how, if it's not on the internet, it's not real. You know what I'm saying? So what we got is basically this understanding that everything you got going on, you got to post it. You have to post it. You know what I'm saying? And people think that the people who have the best posts are doing the best in life, which is really funny. Which is really funny. Because I know some people who are in some situations. Situations you don't want to be in, you don't want to be a part of, you don't, you know what I'm saying? You don't even care for. And they just have really good outfits when they, you know, while they're going through it. You know what I'm saying? So they just post the picture, and you got to make sure that you're not looking at the camera. because that makes a good post. Don't look at the camera. Look at your feet, as a matter of fact. Look down, look away. It doesn't matter. You're always looking for something. We don't want to see your face straight on, okay? So just have a good outfit on and write a caption about growth, and we won't know and we won't care that your bank account is in hell, that you got debt up to your fucking neck, you know, because you got good outfits while you're doing it. And that's what we want. That's what we want to see. And that's what we want to fucking know. All right. So shout out to that. That's growth. You know, I learned how to put my clothes on better. Growth. You know what I mean? And as any, and as anybody hears me saying this, they, you know, it's you. You know it's you. Putting your clothes on better. Great. 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 You know, not to say that there's no merit to that. You know, I learned how to put my clothes on better. You know, and when people see you, you know, with your clothes on right, I mean, we assume that people who can dress well just have things going for them. And that's so true, because even if you go on a job interview or something like that, the first thing you need to do is dress up, you know, dress the fucking part. You know, that's the first thing that we want to see. You can put on the I know everything costume. You know, whether or not you actually know everything is secondary to that. Because above all else, you got to be convincing. That's all we want to be, convinced. You know, truth is too hard to determine. You know, convincing, though, that's a feeling. If I feel convinced, I'm going to nod my head, I'm going to squint my eyes, you're good to fucking go. You know what I mean? You know what happens when I'm posting on the internet, what people get convinced of? People get convinced that I'm really, really short. Okay? It doesn't matter where I'm at. You know what? I don't stand next to anything when I post. So there's just no indicator. You know what I'm saying? So people think that I'm really, really, really tiny. You know? And they feel like they should be just way taller than me. I have people who pull up on me and they realize I'm like a normal sized human being. And sometimes they're the same size as me or smaller. And they are upset. It's upsetting for them. You know, or maybe they're disappointed. I can't tell what it is. You know, so they try to make me smaller. You know, try to make me into a small thing. And I'm like, guy, I already know I'm a small thing. You know, I'm a small thing on this planet. Like, I get it. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to say it back to me. You know, especially when ladies do this, it's so funny. It's so funny. Like, you can't be smaller than me calling me small. You can't be fucking doing that. All right. Like, what merit do you have? You know, if I'm small, you are minuscule. You're fucking micro. You know what I mean? What are we doing here? You call me small, I'm gonna call you smaller. What the fuck does this happen? Now, there has been times, though, where I have met some ginormous people, you know, and they feel like they were absolutely right. Well, nothing. I got nothing for you guys. You know, I got nothing for y'all. You know, if you meet me and you're fucking gigantic, like, okay, you know what I'm saying? But that's not because I'm small. It's because you big as fuck. Fuck that. Fuck that. Fuck you and fuck that. You know what I'm saying? Like, motherfuckers be talking to me like if I get a shorty who's taller than me, she got to put me in a car seat or something like that. You know what I mean? Like, that's not happening. Like, if I'm in a whip, it's going to look regular. Okay? You ain't got to strap me in. All right? If you want to, though, I mean, what am I going to do? Like, where's the threshold, you know what I'm saying, for what you will and won't do? You know what I mean? Say if I was in a situation where some giant broad said, look, I like you, I want you, I want to be with you, but what I want to do is I just want to pay you every day to just act like a really tiny person. You know what I'm saying? Like, if she's some ginormous chick and I just got to be every day, I just got to be the fucking micro dude, micro man every fucking day, I would do that shit. You know what I'm saying? What you want to do? You want to change my diapers? You want to do that? Or what are you paying, though? You know what I'm saying? Like, what's the stipend? If you're telling me that some woman wants to change my diapers for Like if she giving me like if she dropping a couple hundred G's a month or something like that, tens of thousands of dollars a month. I'm talking about kickback money. Like I could put my feet up. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gotta worry about nothing. She wanna change my diapers. Oh, I'll do that shit. And I'll make a fucking documentary. I'll be that dude. Microman documentary. You know what I'm saying? You wanna put me in a car seat every time we drive in the car, I gotta get in the car seat. You know what I'm saying? And shake around a motherfucking rattle. I'll do that shit. Microman, the documentary. You hear what I'm saying? It don't matter what it is. She could put me in a fucking jumper. I could be dressed like Super Mario. Because that's what kids are dressed like. Super Mario. You put them in a jumper, some shoes and a hat. Super fucking Mario. Microman, the goddamn documentary. We could do that shit. You know what I'm saying? As long as I get the money and as long as I get to smash. All right? And we good. You feel me? Smacking up this giant joint. Because that's when you get your payback. You know what I'm saying? On a smash. It don't matter what she's doing daily. You feel me? Because it's fetish life. Fetish life. You know what I mean? Are you down or are you not? You know what I'm saying? Don C said $1,000 a diaper. That's too low, baby. That's too low. That's too low for me to give up my life. Because I'm a shitting motherfucker. I'm going to tell you that right there. I shit every time I eat. So you're talking about eating three times a day. Shitting three times a day. You're talking about three stacks a day. I mean, that's nice. You know what I'm saying? But we got to milk this. We're talking about a fetish here. You know what I'm saying? 15K a week. Or matter of fact, you 21K. 21K a week. You know? And we talking about four times. 100K. That's not even 100K a month yet. Give me the whole 100. You know what I'm saying? And then we talking. Whole 100 a month. And then we talking. You know what I'm saying? 100K a month will get you to a milli. You know, easy. You know what I mean? We want to get to that milli. You feel me? So we want to do 100K a month. You know what I mean? That'll get you a milli, 1.2. Okay? So you go a little bit over. Okay? Because you could talk shit, you know, about my shorty changing my diapers. You know what I'm saying? But I'm in a spot. I got blow money. I'm out. I'm throwing money, baby. You know what I'm saying? Like, what's the problem? You know what I'm saying? It's the diapers and the wipes. And she paying me. You know what I'm saying? Y'all doing that for your snotty little kids for fucking free. Just for them to grow up and be ungrateful. You know what I'm saying? I will put my feet up, let her change my diapers, and I'll tell her thank you. You know what I'm saying? Grateful. You know what I mean? And take my fucking check. And that's real shit. So you could change my diapers. You could put me in the car seat, you know what I'm saying? You can feed me out the baba, all of that, you know what I'm saying? 100 a month, 100 a month. I'll take it. Because we all just want to be kids anyway. That's all we're doing this for. The only reason why we're doing things as adults is so that we can live like children. You know what I'm saying? As soon as we get the means, you know what I mean? That means you're talking about hit the lotto. We always want to go do some childish shit. You want to go play somewhere, you know? That's what we want to do. We want to go fucking play. Fuck that shit. You know what I mean? You talking about you're going to fast track me to that? All right, fine. You know what I mean? Let's just do a whole childhood in the fucking house. You know what I mean? What you call your man? What you call your woman? Your baby, huh? Yeah, all right. Change my diapers. And that's real shit. Yeah, Cav, we on the dark talks. You know what I'm saying? We on the dark talks. You know what I mean? And that's what it is, Don C's. Yes, diapers. You feel me? And that's why I call strippers. I call them strippies too, because they deserve your respect. You know what I'm saying? They deserve your respect and they deserve your gratitude. You know what I'm saying? Dropping ass and popping ass like never before. That's the metric for all these chicks that you see in the club and your shorty who should be doing the same thing at fucking home. That's the metric. Strippers. They take it to the next motherfucking level so that we know where the line is. You know what I'm saying? Where everything's supposed to be. How far is too far? You know what I'm saying? Stripper level, that's how far is too far. You only know that because they exist. You know what I mean? So shout out to them. You know what I'm saying? Yes, yeah, Cav. We just get me breastfed. Get me breastfed. You know what I'm saying? Now with like real live breastfeeding, would that be going too far? You walking on the line with me. That's like, that's right on the line. I think you start to make it to CNN. If you talking about a big grown motherfucker, I'm a gray-haired man. You talking about breastfeeding? If it gets out that I'm getting breastfed, boy, Microman, the documentary is going global, boy. I'm talking about BBC gonna have me on their shit. You feel me? Real shit. Real shit. I might even put an ad on Craigslist right now. Real shit. Microman, the documentary. I need it. You know what I'm saying? I need some giant woman. You know what I'm saying? Baby and me around. Make that happen. You feel me? Because what is it? What is it all worth? What is it all worth? You know? How long can I do that for? 1-2 years? You know, that'll be very eventful. 1 or 2 years. You know what I'm saying? You can make Microman a documentary. And then make a fucking $10 million off of that. You know, Microman the movie. You know, make another $40 million off of that. And I had to give up 1 or 2 years of my masculinity. You think that after Microman the documentary drop and all that money start coming in, you think some chick that I pull up on is going to be like, oh, you was the dude who had the woman changing his diapers, right? Nah, I'm not with the shits. Fuck no. She's gonna be like, oh man, you did the thing. You cashed out. She's gonna get nervous that she's gonna have to be changing my diapers now. She might think that that's a thing that I want and I like. You know what I'm saying? She's gonna have to get ready. You know, if you never, you know, as a man, or even a woman. You know what I'm saying? If you ever been in a situation where you have somebody, you being with somebody, and sometimes there's a conversation where you realize that they ready to change for you. You know what I'm saying? And they ask you about something, and it starts out with, do I have to? You know what I'm saying? You know, like I had a shorty one time who was really trying to lock in, and she was like, do I have to learn how to like do your hair? And like, and that's when it strikes you. It's like, okay, this person is trying to conform to your lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? So if it get out, you know what I'm saying, that she was changing little diapers and wiping a little butt, you know what I'm saying? And like, if I got used to that, you know what I'm saying? I'm talking about holding my two echoes up. You know what I'm saying? And you wiping my butt, changing my diapers, and like that's, I feel like that's what the conversation would be. You know what I'm saying? Like every chick I press, she's just gonna be like, I mean, I'm with the shits, but do I gotta wipe a butt, change little diapers? And I'm just gonna be like, yes, yes, fucking do it. You know what I'm saying? Do it. You think after 1 or 2 years of somebody else wiping my butt, you think I'm gonna go back to doing that shit myself? Fuck no. Fuck no. Okay, I want you to wash these dishes. I want you to wash these clothes. And when it's done, you do another load. I'm talking about the one in my diaper. Okay, put it on a list. Add it up. You feel me? Because what the fuck does it matter? Make a request, okay? Every time somebody's with you, there's going to be stuff that you got to do. Stuff you expected to fucking do, okay? And if you got to wipe a little butt, yo, fucking do it. You know what I mean? The fuck else are you doing? Jeez Louise. I'm crying on that one again. Okay, how did we even get there, right? Doesn't matter. Life is happening. Okay, life is happening. It's happening in way too many ways. We have to narrow it down. Okay? That means we might have to get rid of some people on this planet, but it's all good. Too many people on the planet. That's why a lot of the stuff that's happening is happening right now. That's why we got a lot of this dumb shit that we got, including me, including this podcast. Too many people on the planet, all right? Some people would have gone down already if not for all of this, you know, modern technology and modern medicine and shit. You know what? And that's so true that I'm always watching fucking animal videos. You know what I'm saying? I forget who I was watching videos with. And it was like, you know, it was like lions and shit and hyenas. Hyenas is a nice one to watch. If you're watching fucking animal videos, watch hyenas. All right. Interesting. Because they so small, but they be fucking people up. And animals know this because bigger animals really don't be trying to fuck with them. And I think I was watching videos with somebody and they were saying, yo, why? You know, it was lions and hyenas. And it was like, yo, why the lion don't just shred them? Don't just fucking shred them. You know what I'm saying? Like, even if you take one, shred them. You know, it's because that's coming out the brain of a person who knows modern medicine. You understand what I'm saying? Fuck that. If you a lion and you get bit even a little bit, you get a little scar, you get a little cut, you get a little scrape. Yo, that could be the end of you. You know what I'm saying? You get a little broken ribs, whatever. That could be the end of you. It's staying like that. You know, it's staying like that. There's no doctor. They don't go to the fucking lion doctor and be like, all right, I'm going to take this motherfucker down. And then when I'm done and I'm fucked up, I'm going to the lion doctor. No, you probably going to die tomorrow. You know what I'm saying? Because that's what it is. You know, they really be rubbing dirt in it. They rub dirt in the wounds, you know, and that's it. You feel me? So that's why a lion don't just shred the fucking hyenas. The prospect of him getting a scratch, you know, is dire. It's life or death. You understand what I'm saying? They ain't out there catching colds and taking medicine. You feel me? That's real life right there. And that's why we do the dumb shit that we do. Because we break ourselves and we sure something out there will fucking fix it. Okay? So I'm saying all that to say, fellas, lady gets a little bit out of line. You could break her a little bit. Somebody will fix her. You know what I'm saying? Somebody will do it. And I'm not saying go as far as spousal abuse. Spousal abuse, shout out to that. Shout out to that. Does anybody have interventions for that? Do we have interventions for that? I know we have it for drugs, but it's like drugs, we get it by now. This is a choice that people are making, you know what I'm saying? And they're addicted to it. I guess it affects people, and I get it. But if you beating your man or your woman ass, like, I feel like we should be having interventions for that. This should be spousal abuse intervention. Like, your family should sit you down and like, I know you beating your shorty ass. You need to stop. You know what I'm saying? We don't do that, you know, which is insane. I think that would be a lot more helpful. But those would probably be a lot more frequent, too. And what if my shorty's beating my ass? You know what I'm saying? I don't think her friends would have an intervention. I think her friends would cheer. I think they would cheer. Because that's what ladies do. They support each other no matter what, which is the problem. You know what I'm saying? When shorty is just 40 pounds overweight and her clothes is 3 times undersized, they just compliment each other, which is fucking insane. That's a form of psychosis for sure. For sure. You know what I'm saying? For that reason, I'm glad I'm a dude. You know, if I'm looking crazy, my guys tell me, you look crazy, guy. Go home. Go home and fix that. Go home and fucking fix that. But yeah, spousal abuse intervention should be a fucking thing. You know, on both sides. You know what I mean? If you a shorty and you beating your man ass, you're an abuser too. Okay, know that. You're not standing up for women when you fucking do that. You just beating your guy ass. That's all that is. Because you know he's the lion, you know, and you the hyena. He's not going to shred you. You know, even though he could and he should, you know, he's just not going to do it. You know, the prospect that things might not go his way after that is high. It's high. You see how we just tie those two things together? It's natural. It's nature. It's the fucking, this is all Nat Geo, National Geographic. That's what all this is. Okay? Because I'm a fucking scientist. I'm a fucking scientist. Okay. And that's real shit. And I mean, we're almost at the 1 hour mark. That means this podcast is going to come to an end. And what did I learn in this podcast right now? I learned we spent way too much time talking about Microman, the documentary. But that shit sounds fire. That shit sounds fire. You know what I mean? Somebody needs to do that. And they need to, along with those guys who have like, who get a giant woman to just like fuck them up, you know, and they think that shit is sexy, like step on them and beat them up and tell them to do stuff. Like, that shit is insane. That shit is insane. you know, I don't get it. But those guys need a louder voice, I feel like. You know what I'm saying? They got shit going on in their head. The wires are crossed for sure. The wires are crossed for sure. You know, but maybe we'll hear from them one day. But all right, Hubies. You know what I mean? We did it. We made it. We're back. All right. And we're gonna keep this ball rolling for a little while longer. You know, we got Christmas, New Year's coming up. You got people with their hands out wanting things. All right. Fuck those people. You know, 'tis the season, but also fuck those people. You know what I mean? And fuck that whole shit. You know. So, we hit Highland High. That was fun. We did Bend Backwards and He's Ridiculous. We got Microman, the documentary out of this. You know what I'm saying? And we really need to take that and run with it somewhere. But all good, man. All good. You know, and now the live is telling me that I got 8 seconds left. And that's great because we're done here. All right. So above all else, I'm back. You're here. Fuck y'all.